Dear all, welcome to the playlist of Power Electronics. In this video, I will be discussing the switching characteristics of Power BJT. In the previous session, we have discussed the construction and modes of operation of Power BJT. Today, let's get to understand what is the switching characteristics of Power BJT. First of all, let us understand what is switching characteristics. Okay, what is switching characteristics? Okay, let's come to the point. You know that this device BJT that can be operated up to 1 kilohertz. Okay, and also switching, high switching frequency operation is need to be done, especially these kind of switches. That means the switching characteristics are very important, particularly if you are operating the device at high frequency. That means we are to define the device velocity in changing from on state to off state and vice versa. That means conduction state to blocking state and vice versa. Okay, so that is the importance of the switching characteristics. And also we can able to predict the losses. We can able to calculate the switching losses. Okay, switching losses can be computed by plotting the switching characteristics. And also device selection is also possible. Selection of the device. Selection of device. If you look at the data sheet, you will be getting the good idea about the switching characteristics. That varies depends on the Power BJT. Now, please consider the circuit diagram. You can able to see an NPN transistor and we are providing a base supply. So, we are providing the pulses like this. So, we are providing the pulse look like this. Okay, VB means a pulse. Whenever we are providing the VB, there is a continuous flow of base current IB. IB will be directly passing through the base terminal, where IB is called current. So this is, that is why it is known as current control device. And once VB, you can able to see VB, right? Once the VB is greater than VB is saturated value, obviously you can see the output current. Output current will be flowing from collector to emitter path. So there will be flow of output current IC. That you can able to observe very clearly. Now let us come to the point. In case of switching characteristics, you can see different parameters. VB means gate impulse. IB means current, current through the gate. IC is nothing but output current, or you can call it as collector current. VC means voltage across collector and emitter terminal. That is called VCE. So you can call it as output voltage. Hope these are the parameters you could understand by looking at the circuit diagram. And these parameters are plotted against the time. You can see the time. So that is why it is called a switching characteristics. Okay, now let us plot the characteristics, especially the output current and output voltage during on condition as well as off condition. First, let us talk about the on condition. Do you know when transistor, this kind of Power BJT ons? Yes, the continuous base current need to be passed. And also the base emitter voltage should be greater than the value of base emitter saturated value of voltage. Thus, the device will be getting on. So, let's understand the turn on process. Okay, so what are the major steps involved in the turn on process? So, let us note down turn on process. Turn on, or you can write it as turn on process. Please write it separately. So, all of you please note down. Turn on process. Okay. So first of all, you have to apply the base voltage. Look at this. Square pulse. So this will be the on period. You can see this is your on period. And this must be the off period. Hope you are very clear. So complete pulse is segmented into on period and off period. So this this period is known as total time period. Okay. Do understand. As soon as we provide the base voltage, you can see the flow of base current. See, like this. This is your on period. Look at this. T on. Let me write it as T off. From here to here, we can write it as T off. And the cycle will be repeating. Now, let's understand. During turn on process, what are the specialty? What will happen for the output current and output voltage. Output current is nothing but collector current. Yes. When I provide the base voltage, you can see the base current is flowing here. So initially, you can say that the transistor will not on. But however, a small amount of current, see, look at this, a small amount of current that is still flowing in this area. Small amount of current. So you can able to see that current, some literature says that it's a leakage current. Small amount of current, very minute amount of current will be flowing. But it is above zero, but the value will be very much less. That point you can note out. So at that time, what about the voltage? So you can look at the voltage. What's the speciality of the voltage? So listen here. The device is not on. So the switch is under off condition only. So let me mark like this. Switch is under off condition only. Look at this. So let me mark in this manner. Switch is still under off condition. Like this. Okay. So this is actually the output current and this will be the output voltage. Clear? So this time is known as, we can write it as, please note down, that particular time is known as delay time, TD. 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 TD means delay time. Delay time. Now, let me keep on increasing the base current. Once VB greater than VB saturated, what is going to happen? The device is started turning on. Okay. So you can able to see the growth of current in this manner. So output current is start increasing in this manner. Look, in this manner. So just like a ramp graph will be getting. Ramp. Okay. So a straight line you can able to see. At the same instant, what about the voltage? See, voltage is coming down. Look at this. That means device is going to turn on. No? So what I can say, when the device is turning on, the voltage will be coming down. Output voltage will be coming down. Correct, no? So when the switch is on means the current is going to infinity, voltage is coming to zero. Same manner. So it will be reaching like this. So this particular time period is known as, what is the time period? Rise time. See, current is getting, the value of current is getting increased. So we can able to write, this duration is known as TR. TR. So here also you can mark, this is TD and this point is called TR. TR is known as rise time. See, let me mark this point. Between these two points you can call rise time. Between these two points you can call it as delay time. Afterwards, once the device is on, it still keep on continuing. Still keep on continuing unless and until you are maintaining the gating pulse. Okay, you are maintaining the gating pulse. It is still keep on continuing up to this point. Look at this. Okay. And also the device, what I can say, what about the voltage? Oh, the voltage will be in the same state only. Clear? So this type is known as conduction type, TN. TN or you can call it as TC. Okay. So better represent it as TN. TN is known as conduction period. You can mention it as conduction period, TN. Okay. Device will be under on condition. Okay. Now, we can able to write the total turn on time can be written as, T on can be written as delay time plus rise time. So delay time will be like from here to here, delay time. Rise time means when the current, output current start increasing, that is called a rise time. And TN is nothing but the conduction time, on time. Okay, conduction means the device will be completely on. However, we consider turn on time is the sum of delay time and rise time. Hope you understood. Now tell me how to turn off the particular power BJT. You have to apply the negative pulse. This is positive pulse, this will be negative pulse. I mean, or pulse corresponding to on, and this is actually pulse corresponding to off. Okay. Now immediately we have to remove the pulse. Immediately we have to remove the pulse. That means current has to be reduced. Base current has to be reduced to zero. So look at this. Base current I am trying to reduce to zero. Alright. So see the dotted points. Okay. Now please listen here. So I have removed the gating pulse. And in parallel current is also has to be reduced to zero. But the device will still keep on continuing. Keep on conducting. That means of the same state will be continued. Because some amount of charges that is stored already in the layer. Okay, it's a semiconductor device. Some amount of charge will be stored. So that is called TS. TS is nothing but storage time. Due to some amount of charges stored in the layer, we can say that TS is known as storage time. What is the specialty of this? So even though you are removing the base current to zero, still the device will be conducting for certain time. So I have marked like this. This is actually your TS. Please note on the marker. You will understand TS. Okay, that is called storage time. Now wait for the completion of that particular time, storage time. So afterwards, what is observation you can see? Afterwards we can able to see that there is a droop. We can see that the current is falling down. See, look at this. Current started falling down. So current will be falling down like this. Current is started falling down. It is very clearly visible. In parallel, what about the voltage? See, that means device is moving to blocking state or off state. So voltage started increasing, voltage started rising. Current is coming down and voltage started increasing. So this particular time is called as the falling time. So because current is falling, no? So may I mark it as TF. So this is called TF, fall in time or fall off time. Fall off time, let us call it as fall time or fall off time. Okay. So TF, I'll be writing it as TF, fall time. Okay, fall time. Thereafter, the process will be continuing. Okay, so process will be continuing. So once afterwards we can say that the process will be still keep on repeating. So total turn of time, T of, can be written as, what are the segments? One is storage time, another one is called fall off time or fall time. Simply we can call it as fall time. Okay, so turn of time is segmented into TS plus TF. These are the important equation you can able to mention. So, and also TN will be represented. So this TN, you can see the TN. Okay, TN is known as conduction. See, look at this. This is your conduction period, TN, conduction. Okay. So let us conclude the session. In this session, we studied about what do we mean by switching characteristics of power BJT. Why switching characteristics need to be studied? Because in order to select the device, we need to calculate the switching losses has to be computed, PL, switching losses. So to measure the switching losses, we have to study the switching characteristics. That means we can able to predict the time from one state to on state to off state and vice versa. Clear? So that is why we have to consider the switching characteristics. Then I have plotted how to plot the characteristics. There are two periods. One is on period, another one is called off period. During off period, what are the specialty? See, here this is actually the on period. This will be the off period, and TN is known as conduction time during the steady state operation. Okay, conduction time. And finally, I have divided on time and off time by using different segments. The on time means TD plus TR, and off time means TS plus TF. Okay, so this is about the switching characteristics of power BJT. In the coming session, I am going to discuss about the switching limits of power BJT. Finally, thank you very much for watching this video.